dog. Like a member of the wedding party still to come down the aisle, right? Yesterday at the rehearsal, we said that no matter what happens, no offense to the two of you, the best thing about the wedding will be Milo, so. Dearly beloved, welcome and good afternoon. Yes. Welcome and good afternoon. We gather in the presence of God to give thanks for the gift of marriage, to witness to the joining together of Jack and Lolly, to surround them with our prayers, and to ask God's blessing upon them so that they may be strengthened for their life together and nurtured in their love for God and for each other. God gave us marriage so that those who join in marriage may help and comfort each other, living faithfully together in plenty and in want, in joy and sorrow, in sickness and in health throughout their days. God gave us marriage for the full expression of our love. In marriage, two people belong to each other, and with affection and tenderness, freely give themselves to each other. In marriage, two people are called to a new way of life, created, ordered, and blessed by God, and so it must be entered into prayerfully, responsibly, with the best interest of the other in mind. We rejoice that marriage is given and blessed by God and sustained by the Spirit of love. Therefore, let marriage be held in honor among all. Would you all pray with me? Gracious God, you are always faithful in your love for us. Look mercifully upon Lolly and Jack, whom you have drawn together, who have come seeking your blessing. Let your Spirit rest upon them so that with steadfast love, they may honor the promises they make this day through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. Most of us have come here today to celebrate these two people, but these two people have come here for a far more specific reason today. And so to the two of you, I ask you a question, each of you in turn. Jack, understanding that God has created, ordered, and blessed the covenant of marriage, do you affirm your desire and intention to enter into marriage?
I do.
And Lolly, understanding that God has created, ordered, and blessed the covenant of marriage, do you affirm your desire and intention to enter into marriage?
Absolutely.
This is not simply a union of two people, but also a union of two families. Between them, Lolly and Jack have three daughters who are here today to affirm and celebrate the union of their parents. So I invite the three of them forward to stand with their parents and to do publicly what they are already doing privately, which is to offer their support and love. To the three of them, I ask, do you give your blessing to Jack and Lolly? And do you promise to do everything in your power to uphold them in their marriage? And of course, these three women are also feeling their family shift today as well. So I ask a question to the parents. Lolly and Jack, I ask, do you promise to be a family to them and to offer them your support and your love?
We do.
We do.
Thank you. You can have a seat. We come to the part of the ceremony for the exchange of vows, where you each will make promises to each other. Lolly, we will start with you. Repeat after me. I, Lolly, take you, Jack, to be my husband.
I, Lolly, take you, Jack, to be my husband.
And I promise before God and these witnesses.
And I promise before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
In plenty and in want.
What was that?
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live. And Jack, would you repeat after me? I, Jack, take you, Lolly, to be my wife.
I, Jack, take you, Lolly, to be my wife.
And I promise before God and these witnesses.
And promise before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
It is traditional to exchange rings as an outward sign of the inward promises that Jack and Lolly have made to each other. May we have the rings. Lolly, we will start with you again. Repeat after me. Jack, I give you this ring as a sign of our covenant.
Jack, I give you this ring as a sign of our covenant.
Wear it as a promise and a reminder of our love.
Wear it as a promise and a reminder of our love.
Which follows you wherever you go.
Which follows you wherever you go.
Jack. Lolly, I give you this ring as a sign of our covenant.
Lolly, I give you this ring as a sign of our covenant.
Wear it as a promise and a reminder of our love.
Wear it as a reminder of our promise and our love.
Which follows you wherever you go.
Which follows you wherever you go.
To all the friends and all the family who are gathered here today, and to everyone who is on the live stream, and to everyone who is here in spirit, who love these two people. Before God and before you, Lolly and Jack have made their solemn vows to each other. They have confirmed their promises by the giving and receiving of rings. Therefore, I proclaim that they are now husband and wife, those whom God has joined together. Let no one separate. The couple may kiss. Hear now this blessing, a blessing on Jack and Lolly, but also on all of you who are gathered here. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord be kind and gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.